That means that this house will average growth of 4% a year. So what is 4% of 400,000? That's $16,000 a year in future wealth that I'm building by just holding the property. This house will give me a $101,000 tax deduction. So I can go out to wholesale, I can go fix and flip, I can go run other businesses and make 100 grand over in that business tax-free. There's 5 benefits to buying a property. What are the benefits? I've got Josh Bowenzi and Kevin Cho with me. 19-year-old on his way to making $200,000 this year. Last year, how much did you make?
12 grand.
12 grand from 12,000 to $200,000 in 1 year. Kevin Cho on his way to making $600,000 this year?
600,000.
As a 22-year-old non-licensed wholesaler who understands creative finance, we are at a property that I just bought from these two gentlemen. Now, what we're gonna do today in this video is we're gonna give you guys a walkthrough. I want you making comments, talking about what you think we're gonna do with this property, and I'll tell you at the end. We're gonna talk about where the deal came from, where the pain came from, who was involved, and how everybody got paid. We're gonna walk through that starting with Josh. Josh, where the hell did this deal come from?
So this was on market for about 3 months when I called the agent. I pitched subject to terms. I told them that your seller won't have to come out of pocket to sell the house now. We'll be able to close in 3 weeks, so you'll be able to get out of here pretty quickly.
All right.
The agent seemed pretty interested in the offer. They said no at first, but a month later they called me back and they accepted our terms.
Okay, so this house was on market for 3 months, meaning a real estate agent was representing a seller.
Yeah.
You called and you said, hey, it looks like the seller has low equity.
Yeah.
So you guys went on PropStream probably, yes. Pulled a low equity on market list, called the agent, and you pitched terms.
I did, yeah.
Did the agent even know what creative finance or subject to was?
She did not, but she was pretty open to hearing about the terms, which made the process a lot easier.
Okay, great. So what was the motivation of the seller?
It was a couple, they were not married, breaking up, going their separate ways, so. Yeah.
So they bought the house together, they decided, hey, let's just sell the house, get rid of it, so we can move our separate ways and not have a house holding us down.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Agent couldn't sell the house. Agent also didn't understand creative finance, so you boys stepped in and you guys helped the agent understand creative finance.
Exactly.
Okay, how much did the agent get paid on this?
Agent made 11 grand.
11 grand? Yeah. So the agent went from, and by the way, look at this house. Like, is this house not pretty dope? Would you live here?
I would live here if it was not in Casa Grande.
Yeah, Casa Grande's pretty far. But what, you know what's happening in Casa Grande that's really exciting and why I want to buy down here?
All the big companies are moving down.
Like what? What's a big company moving down here?
Lucid,
Rivian, bunch of companies are moving down here, putting $4 billion plants out here. There's gonna be water parks, all sorts of stuff. So they couldn't sell a house that's perfectly fine. Like granite countertops, beautiful cabinets. You've got, this is a great layout.
This is big, new construction.
New construction. Yeah. This thing's like less than 2 years old.
Yeah.
Couldn't sell it. Mm-hmm. We bought it subject to, so you guys got it under contract and you guys assigned it to me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so agent makes $11,000. How much did you guys make?
It was a assignment fee of 10 grand that we both split.
Okay, so agent gets 11, you guys get 10.
Mm-hmm.
How much did the seller get?
Seller walked away with 7.
Seller walked away with 7. So the seller is probably ecstatic because they weren't able to sell the house.
They weren't gonna make anything. They were gonna have to cut a check.
So guys, if you're a real estate agent out there struggling to get deals done, creative finance solved this agent's problem. It solved the seller's problem. The seller is going through a divorce. Again, if you guys want to go PropStream link down below in the comments, or not in the comments, but in the description, you'll be able to find a link to go to PropStream. What's the purchase price of the house?
Purchase price was $393,000.
$393,000. Okay, so is this house worth $393,000? I'm not sure. I can tell you that it probably is not.
It's not.
Okay, it's probably not worth $393,000, but why would somebody like me buy this property? Well, I didn't buy the property in my mind. I bought the interest rate. I got a great interest rate. I didn't have to use my credit, no credentials. What interest rate did I get when I bought this house subject to?
You got a 4%.
4%. How much are interest rates right now?
7.8.
And they're going up.
Yeah.
So I've got half the rate of anybody else because I took over a payment that nobody else was able to take over.
Yeah.
Okay, what is our payment on this house?
It's 2,200.
2,200 bucks. Amazing. All right, let's take a look at this. $2,200. I wonder what we could rent this property for. Ben, what do you think about the house? Do you think anything needs to be done here?
I would change the drapes.
What? Come on, bro.
Love the paint.
Okay, what about the carpet? I feel like the carpet is the one thing I hate. If you're gonna rent a property, it's almost like get rid of this carpet and just do linoleum. Mm. But I could just rent it out right now, but I don't think I'm gonna do a regular rental. What do you guys think I would do in this property?
I have a Jacob Kadic is doing rent by the rooms.
Okay, so Jacob Kadic is the gentleman that I sold my F-150 to. If you guys want a link to that video, we'll put it up here so you guys can click on it. I sold my F-150 to Jacob Kadic. It was a truck that's worth $22,000 cash, but I sold it to him for $47,000 on seller finance. Go watch that video up here. But Jacob Kadic is doing rooms by their rent by the room in Casa Grande because there's so many engineers and so many people moving here for all the job growth, but there's not enough houses. So I think that that's probably the direction I'm gonna go.
Yeah.
So let's talk about if I've got a $2,200 payment, let's figure out what could I make in this property if I did a rent by the room. The primary bedroom, I already know I can rent for like $980 a month because that person has a dedicated bathroom. Okay, so let's go over here. Let's look at how many other bathrooms I have. I probably could turn this room right here into another bedroom. Oh, easy. This is easy. Like, boom, right? You turn this into another bedroom, just throw up a wall. This is a bedroom by itself. So now I have a second bedroom. So let's do the math on this. I've got 980. 980 bucks plus this room would be rented out for 750 a month. So I'm already at 1730 bucks. Okay? I could then do this bedroom is a third and this one is a fourth. So let's add another $1,500 to this. So my rent rate is at 3,230 bucks a month. I still don't think that's enough. Okay, what would I do here if I want to do rent by the rooms and I wanted to amplify this?
Would you
add a bathroom on a
Turn the garage into
a bedroom. Cool, now let's, okay, that's just a laundry room. All right, cool. So let's take a look. I walk into the garage. I'm going to have a hallway, and there's going to be a door here and a door here. And I'll have two bedrooms in the garage with two mini splits. And now I can rent the property for $4,730 bucks a month.
Wow.
Not bad. But let's do the math on this, okay?
Yeah.
If I have $4,730 a month, I multiply that by 0.9. Why am I multiplying that by 0.9?
Vacancy.
Okay, you're always gonna have some sort of vacancy and evictions and all that kind of stuff, so you just take 10% right off the top. Let's do the math again. 980 plus 750 plus 750 plus 750 plus 1500. Yes. My gross rents are gonna be 4,730 bucks a month. Okay. I'm gonna multiply that by 0.9, which means 10% vacancy, so I'm at 4,257 per month, okay?
Yeah.
Now I take out my pad split management fee, and I'm still left with $3,618 a month. Utilities, cable, cleaning, miscellaneous like uh-oh moments, all that kind of stuff. I'm only gonna take out 750 for that. So now I'm left with 2,868. What is my payment on this?
22.
So I'm gonna take out my 2,200 bucks. And my net on this property is not that fantastic. 668 bucks a month.
Yeah.
But that's still pretty good.
Right.
Right, $668 per month is what I will net on this property. What are my benefits here? Let's go through all the benefits, okay? There's five benefits to buying a property. What are the benefits? Number one?
Cash flow.
What's my cash flow on the property?
668.
668 bucks per month net in my pocket, right? Second thing.
Appreciation,
future growth. Okay, Google this for me right now and say Casa Grande average appreciation yearly. Google that real fast.
4.4.
Okay, so if I bought the property for 400,000, that means that this house will average growth of 4% a year. So what is 4% of 400,000?
16,000.
That's $16,000 a year in future wealth that I'm building by just holding the property. Yeah, so think about this. You own a property in Casa Grande that's like a new build like this, over the next 10 years, the average appreciation will be more than 4%. But that's okay, that is probably pulling the last 20 years.
Yeah.
Okay. So I got $668 per month, multiply that by 12, that's $8,000 a year in cash flow, plus $12,000 a year in appreciation. I'm already at 20 grand a month, 20 grand a year on this property.
Yeah.
Okay, let's now talk about depreciation. How much in tax savings will I get this year from owning this property? Let's do the math for the people at home. 400,000 divided by 27.5, that's the IRS's code for tax benefits. So yearly I get 14,000. And if I decide to take 7 years up front, that means this house will give me a $101,000 tax deduction So I can go out to wholesale, I can go fix and flip, I can go run other businesses and make $100,000 over in that business tax-free. That's pretty cool.
That's awesome.
That's in my first year.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, what are the other ways I make money? So it's cash flow, appreciation, depreciation. What's the fourth thing I get when I buy properties like this? Fourth one is pay down. Yeah. So am I paying down the mortgage or are the tenants paying down the mortgage?
Tenants are.
So at 4% interest, my $2,200 payment, I'm probably paying down somewhere around $800 a month on my mortgage. Either $1,400 is going to interest. So $800 a month is paying down on my debt here every single month on top of my cash flow, on top of my appreciation, on top of my tax benefits.
And you're paid down way quicker later.
Yeah, it'll go way, way, way faster the longer I own this property.
Yeah.
Okay, so what's the long-term play with a house like this? How long do you think I'll own it?
Forever.
Probably 30 years. And what I'll do is every 10 years, I'll refinance out a couple $100,000 and go buy more. Another 10 years, refinance another couple $100,000. And there you go. So for people that are watching this now, do you think that anybody can do this business?
I do.
Yes, 100%.
What do you think stops people from jumping in a business like this?
Friends.
What do you mean by that, friends?
Like they don't think they can do it themselves because none of the people in their family, friends, circle are doing it.
Great answer.
Because for me, like I'm hanging out with people that are doing it like every other day. So it's like if I'm not doing it, then I'm like being left behind.
Hey, somebody DM'd me today and they said, I've never seen a sub two deal get done ever. Do they really exist?
Yeah.
And you want to laugh about that because you're just like, are you kidding me? Like, how is that not, it's happening every day. In fact, you guys even turn some deals down.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So agent gets paid $11,000, seller gets paid $7,000. You guys get paid $10,000 on this deal.
Yes.
And we went through a title company.
Yes.
And where's the seller now? Where'd the seller go?
Both got an apartment somewhere in Casa Grande.
Amazing. So they stayed in Casa Grande. Okay, great. What Facebook group do you think people should join if they are watching a video like this for the first time? Where could they get help?
People should definitely go to the Creative Finance with Pace Morby Facebook group. The link will be down below because right now I'm working. It's already Monday morning. It's only 10 in the morning and I'm already working on two step two deals here in Arizona right now.
All right, Ben and I are fighting about this a little bit, guys. I know I can rent out the garage. I know I can rent out all those other bedrooms, but we're debating, could I rent out this laundry room? Come check this out. Ben thinks I should. I think he's freaking crazy. So let's take a look at this. Make a comment. Who do you think is right? This little laundry room right here, Ben thinks we could turn into a bedroom. Make a comment down below if you guys think we should turn this into a bedroom or leave it as a laundry room. Say Ben for laundry room, Pace for no laundry room down in the comments down below. See you in the next video.